Hello ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Exotic Astrology, and today we are back with another example chart for showing extraordinary success in your career and super duper success in career field, mainframe position. Because many times people want to know how much name and fame they will get, or how much famous they will become, or how much power authority they will have. So here I have another example chart, and due to security reasons I will not be revealing the birth information of this person. And this person is very successful in his career and is now in a very big leadership position in the company, and this person is into the finance sector, accounts, finance and business accounting, and this person is growing day by day, as in Hindi they say din dugni raat chogni tarakki. So what are the combinations which this person has in his chart which has led him to such heights? Okay, we will try to discuss these combinations, and there are thousands of combinations which are there, and he does not have all of them. He has some of them, but he has quite a few of them, and therefore it is essential that we discuss those combinations. And also there are many difficulties and negativities and challenges in this chart as usual, but as I always tell that we should try to see the good in chart, in the charts, as in people also. So if we find faults or negativities with the charts, then we will also find faults with people. Okay, so instead of directly criticizing some placements which he has, which are obviously very challenging, let us try to see the good. All right. And as usual, if you are new to the channel, then please subscribe to it. And if you want a consultation from me regarding your career or name fame, you can always go to the description section of my website, of my videos, down below I mean, where you will find the link to my website. And yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you shall find him. Alright, so which are the houses of name and fame? Well, the houses of name and fame are primarily the Lagna and the 10th and the 11th. So this is the Lagna chart, and this is the first house, as you can see here. So these are the primary houses of name and fame. Primary, 1st, 10th and 11th. Now there are secondary houses of name and fame, which is the 2nd house, the 6th house and the 5th house and the 9th house. So to the extent you see the lords of these houses sitting together in either of these houses, should I repeat? To the extent you see the lords of these houses sitting in each other's houses, or sitting together with each other in each other's houses, to that extent the person will have fame. So let me grade it down into three categories. So first category is Lagna, 10th and 11th, somehow linked. Then the second is the 2nd and the 6th, somehow linked to these three houses. That will also give you a lot of fame. And the third level of fame will come from the trines, okay? The 5th and the 9th, somehow linked with these houses. The 1st, 10th, 11th, or the 2nd and the 6th. So now, and then after that, you also have to check the Navamsha, about which I will discuss in this video in the second half. So there are many principles which you have to judge when it comes to judging the Navamsha from the Lagna chart. Okay. And that is also very important, because many times people do not judge the Navamsha chart. They just only judge the Lagna chart, and things don't fall into place quite well. Okay, so now let us start. As I said, 1st, 10th and 11th. So you check in this chart. This is number 5, which is Leo ascendant. So who is the Lagna Lord? Sun. Then who is the 10th Lord? Taurus, Venus. Then who is the 11th Lord? It is Mercury. So now you see Mercury and Sun are, Sun, Mercury are placed in the 10th house. So the Lagna Lord is conjunct the 11th Lord sitting in the 10th house. This is the best placement that you can have. And that too, the Lagnesh is in Digbala here. Sun gets directional strength in the 10th house. So there is no better place for the Sun to be in than the 10th house. And the 11th Lord is specially associated with network circles and gains that you make from other people, especially those people who help you to become better individuals. So now this 11th Lord is conjunct the Lagna Lord in the 10th house. So as I said, lords of these houses sitting in each other's houses or sitting together with each other in each other's houses. Okay, so the Lagnesh is with the 11th Lord in the 10th house. Then where is the 10th Lord placed? Venus is in the 11th house. This is a fantastic placement. This is so there is an exchange between the lords of the 10th and the 11th. This is the best combination on earth you can have for money. It is the best. There is no other better combination than 10th Lord, 11th Lord in exchange. It is even better than 10th Lord, 11th Lord sitting together in each other's house. Okay, so imagine Mercury Venus was here or Mercury Venus was here. This is even better because Parivartan Yoga, which happens when planets are sitting in each other's houses, is the strongest form of yoga which you can get in any horoscope. So here the 10th Lord is in the 11th and the 11th Lord is in 10th. But you will see many horoscopes with this yoga, but you will see that they may not be extraordinarily successful in their career. Why? Because the Lagna Lord will be badly placed in those charts if you check. But here in this chart, if you check, the Lagna Lord is placed along with this Parivartan Yoga. So because of this Parivartan, it is said when Parivartan Yoga occurs, then the planets actually change the house and the sign. So for example, here, although Sun is in the 10th house, but it will actually act as if it is in the 11th house, which is even more better. 11th house is the best house for any planet to be in. And even if it was not undergoing this Parivartan, it would still be in the 10th house with this Digbala position. Okay. So now Mercury and Sun, which is participating in this yoga, is actually sitting in the sign of Taurus, which is the sign related to finances, because Taurus especially has to do with finances along with Gemini also, but especially Taurus and to some extent Virgo also. So this is the best combination on earth you can get. 10th Lord, 11th Lord in Parivartan, that is the best combination. There is no better combination than that. And when the Lagna Lord participates in this, this yoga becomes 10 times more powerful. Okay, and that too when the Lagnesh is in Digbala, it's like 100 times more powerful. Then, what is the next thing that I told? The next thing is to check, what about the 2nd and the 6th, okay? So, who is the 2nd Lord here? 2nd Lord is again Mercury, it is again in the 10th house. Who is the 6th Lord? 6th Lord is Saturn, Shani Maharaj. Shani Maharaj is in the Lagna itself. So, again, as I said, 2nd and the 6th associated with these three houses. Very, very good for fame. I have seen very powerful placements. Then the third principle that I gave was the trinal lords or the trines associated with the houses of fame, which is 1, 10, 11 or 2 and 6. So if you check here, Jupiter and Mars, Jupiter is ruling 5th house, number 9 Sagittarius, and Mars rules the 9th. So Jupiter and Mars are both situated in the ascendant. So trinal lords are placed in the ascendant, and this Jupiter moon is conjunct. This is also forming Gaj Kesari Yoga. And I have seen Gaj Kesari Yoga giving more better results, because many people in this world have Gaj Kesari Yoga, but they don't get good results. Why? There are many reasons, but one of the reasons that I have seen is because this Gaj Kesari Yoga is not placed properly from the Lagnesh. So it's like saying the yoga is there, but the person doesn't use it. Okay. But if you check in this chart, from the Lagna, this is in the first house. I mean, it's in the Lagna only. So from the Lagna, it is well placed because it's placed there. And from the Lagnesh, which is Sun, it is in the Kendra. It is in fourth house from Sun. So this is a very, very, very powerful Gaj Kesari Yoga which is happening. This is very powerful. And that too, the sign is Leo, which is a friend sign for both Jupiter and Moon also. And then if you check closely, this Moon Mars are also together here. That is also a very powerful combination for money. It is known as Shashi Mangal Yoga, which means Moon Mars combined. Okay, so these are extraordinary placements. And again, this Moon Mars which is forming here is in Kendra from the Lagna and from the Lagna Lord. Okay, these are extraordinary placements which you will have, and there are many other ways to check. So for example, now let us try to delve into the Navamsha chart. Okay, so the Navamsha chart, in the Navamsha chart there are two planets which we should check specifically. We should check the strength of the 10th Lord and the 11th Lord in the Navamsha chart. Okay, specifically these two planets, 10th Lord of the Lagna chart in the Navamsha and 11th Lord of the Lagna chart in the Navamsha. Okay, both of these are very important when it comes to name and fame specifically. So if you check who is the 10th Lord of the Lagna chart, not of the Navamsha chart, of the Lagna chart, if you see, that's Venus here. So where is Venus placed? Venus is in the fourth house. It is in Digbala in the Navamsha. Okay. And it is placed in Sagittarius, which is a bit challenging for Venus sometimes. But if you try to do things in a focused way, then this is a good placement for Venus, I have observed. So this 10th Lord of the Lagna chart is in Digbala in the Navamsha. So this is like saying that the name and fame for this person is quite destined. So this means this person doesn't have to do much. That is like it is all already predestined from his past life karma. It does not mean that the person does not have to put efforts, but it means that the amount of gains that this person will have is much more than the amount of efforts this person will be putting. Okay, sometimes it happens the opposite. You will see, you know, there are people who put a lot of efforts but they don't get anything in return in life, in certain area of course. So that's a very important fact to notice. So here, because of this Venus being in Digvala, especially in the Navamsha, because Navamsha represents those things which are destined to happen with you, either you like it or you don't. Okay, or even you hate it or you love it, either ways. So this 10th Lord of name and fame is well placed in the Navamsha chart. So this means this is already destined by Lord Vishnu. Lord Vishnu has given him this because of his past karmas. So congratulations to this person on those lines. Then we check the 11th Lord. Who is the 11th Lord? Mercury. Mercury is again in the 9th house. So Mercury is a very crucial planet because Mercury is the Lagna Lord of the Navamsha chart. Okay. The Lagna Lord of the Navamsha chart can show specifically what kind of traits you are very good at learning. Okay, so therefore, what is he very good at learning? He is very good at learning Mercury, which is business and finance, accounts, especially accounts. He is very good at that. And if you see, this Mercury is in the ninth house, which means to learn this skill, he has to go to a good guru or a senior or a guide, and he had also learned all this from a very senior personality. And if you see, Mercury is in Taurus here and Taurus here also. So this Mercury is in a very special dignity, which is known as Vargottama, Varga Uttam, which means this Mercury is in the same sign in both the Lagna chart and the Navamsha chart. So this makes this Mercury extremely prominent, not powerful necessarily. A Vargottam planet is not powerful, it is very prominent. There's a difference between powerful and prominence, being prominent. So because this is very prominent and this is happening in a good place, so here it is happening in the 10th house, here it's happening in the 9th house. So now it is like saying this prominence has become very good for him. So this will add a lot to his life. And therefore, it is highly essential that we check these two planets in the Navamsha itself. Okay. So therefore, this Mercury and Venus become very crucial, and they both of them are very well placed in the Navamsha chart. Okay. And apart from that, you can check the situation of the trinal lords in the Navamsha chart. Okay, so trinal lords means the lords of the trines of the Navamsha, especially. All right, so and in Navamsha, you know, Mercury, Venus can be very far also, because this is the Navamsha chart we are talking about, okay. But in Lagna chart, Mercury, Venus are always very near to each other. So when you see this, how Mercury, Venus are very far, don't get confused. Don't think that this is a false chart, okay. So you check the situation for the trines. So one trinal lord is Saturn, he's in the third house. And the other is again Venus, which is in Digbala. So malefics like Saturn and Rahu and Mars are very good in Upachya houses. Okay. So now Saturn and Mars are placed in Upachya houses here. And because this eighth lord Mars of the Navamsha is in debility, if you see, eighth lord is in debility. So this can mean the misfortunes which this person has will not necessarily affect him very much in his life. Okay, of course this can have many meanings, but this is one of the meanings that I have seen sometimes. So there are multiple things that you can check in the Navamsha. Especially you must check Jupiter and Venus, because Jupiter and Venus gives you that feel good factor which you get when you get anything. Okay, especially when it comes to prize, recognitions, awards, ceremonies. So if you see here, Jupiter is in the 10th house. It's a very good placement for Jupiter, and Venus is in Digbala. So therefore, we can conclude that this chart is a very extraordinary chart for finances. And as usual, as I said again, there are many difficulties in this chart, and about which I did not speak much, because they are there for every other chart. Okay, so for example, if you see, there are three malefics placed in the Lagna, and Ketu's influence is also there somehow. So it's like saying all the malefic influence is there on the Lagna. So this can make things difficult for the person at times. But because this Navamsha is so strong, especially these two planets, as I told you, 10th lord and 11th lord, so Mercury and Venus, because they are so strong, because of that nobody can stop this person, and this person has been taking leaps and bounds in his career and will continue to do so in the future also. Okay, and this person has been very successful, and he has also been very lucky not to have a good horoscope but also to have very good dashas in his life. Okay, so in Vedic astrology, dashas are of primary importance. So if you do not check dashas, then you have not checked anything especially. All right, and if you see currently in transit also, Rahu is transiting his 11th house, because Rahu is in Gemini now till September 2020. So that is also a great placement, and Jupiter has also entered his 5th house. Okay, so Jupiter Rahu's opposition is there in the 5-11 axis. So this has been a phenomenal year. I mean, this year will be a very phenomenal year for him when it comes to transits. And I hope that he keeps going ahead in his career like this and does great work for the entire human civilization. All right. Thank you very much for your patience. And if you like this video, click the thumbs up at the end and watch my other example charts videos. And please subscribe to the channel, and if you want a consultation from me, you could go to the website down in the description section. God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him. Thank you very much.